I love this day. I love you on this day. I want to experience the world with you.
And help you love every minute of my crazy. Love me in my worst and my best. Never let the moment make us forget the journey.
I'll see you at the altar. Your future.
And then back again. take my whole life.
This woman to be married to this man. Come on up. Look beautiful. Welcome to all who have gathered here this day to share in this marriage ceremony of Justin and Christine. The couple has asked that you be present in this moment and requested an unplugged ceremony. With that said, please take this time to capture a quick personal memory and silence your phones and refrain from any additional photos or recordings until after the ceremony. The words spoken today between Justin and Christine are indeed important, but they are not what joins these two together. Nor is it this marriage ceremony. We are not here to witness the beginning of their relationship, but to acknowledge and celebrate a lasting bond that already exists between them. Justin and Christine have already joined their hearts together and chosen to walk together on life's journey. And we have come to bear witness to a symbolic union and a public affirmation of the love that they share. The ceremonial union of two people in marriage is as ancient as our very humanity, and yet is still as fresh as each day's sunrise. The commitment of love between Justin and Christine speaks of their shared experiences together and their dreams for the future, of the importance of each of them as individuals, as well as the special bond they share, and of the importance of their community, of family and friends. Everyone gathered here today was invited to this ceremony because you have played a special role in Justin and Christine's lives. You're present at this ceremony to celebrate their marriage and to witness their vows of love to one another. Will all of you gathered here to witness this union do all in your power to love and support this couple now and in the years ahead? If so, please respond, we will.
We will.
Justin and Christine, have you come here today with the intention to be legally joined in marriage? Do you pledge to choose respect, kindness, and compassion towards one another, to listen deeply to one another, and to speak to one another truthfully today and always? At this time, I'd like to invite the stepfather of the groom, Reggie, to come up and read some scripture from the book of Matthew.
Good afternoon, everyone.
There's no words.
Upon the bride and groom's request, I will be reading from
there's no words in this
scripture. Matthew chapter 19, verses 4 through 6 of the Amplified Bible. Where it says, have you never read that he who made them from the beginning made them male and female, and said, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall be united firmly, joined inseparably to his wife. I repeat that. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall be united firmly, joined inseparably to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, God has joined together. What therefore God has joined together, let not no man put asunder or separate. Amen.
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 Your love is something that you both cherish. So much so that it's moved you to join in the union of marriage and create a home together. Today, you dedicate your lives to giving one another happiness and support. And to be certain, entering the covenant of marriage is an act of deep trust and faith in the strength of your love. Your marriage must be based on the heartfelt and sincere acceptance of one another as you are each moment. The pledge you make today expresses your devotion to one another and to the love that you share. And the words spoken here will support your marriage through the inevitable hardships you'll face together. Today, in the presence of your families and friends, you pronounce your love for each other and make a commitment that will define the next phase of your journey. And at this time, Justin and Christine have prepared their own vows that they'd like to share with each other. Justin, please go ahead.
Christine, your radiance is immeasurable. You hold sovereignty over my joy and a monopoly of my tranquility. I stopped writing poems for you when I began to find it. I began to find it hard to find worthy enough words to describe my love for you. And that's when I knew that I needed you at this altar. Under divine audience, before our beloved witnesses, I knew that I needed you here so I can give you a word, because I have a word for you, and it means everything to me. It's the only thing that I can give you that comes close to what you bring to me, and that word is my word, a promise, an oath, a pledge. I pledge to you my loyalty and unyieldingness to any element of disharmony. It is my sacred and eternal vow to not only love you forever, but to remain inseparable from you, one flesh.
You actually introduced me to Grammarly, and I spent more time than I care to admit trying to write the perfect words for today. And in the end, I decided to throw it all away and just speak from the heart this afternoon in front of our friends and family, and let you know the joy that you've brought to me, to the family, and how easily you folded into the craziness that is essentially us. It's never normal, and I can promise you that it never will be, but I enjoy the journey, and I'm glad that you took the risk to say that you wanted to step into that and be a part of what we have and to continue to develop and grow it beyond that. So I vow to you to be everything that I can, to bring all that you wish, and to continue to help you explore this world outside of your computer. I vow to love you for forever and to ensure that everyone knows that I will love you for forever, regardless of how little or how often I tend to say it.
Wedding rings are symbolic reminders of the unbroken circle of eternal love. Within the safety and comfort of a true marriage, love given freely has no beginning and no end. Love freely given has no separate giver and receiver. Each of you gives your love to the other, and each of you receives love from the other. May these rings serve to remind you of the freedom and power of your love. Sorry, I can't reach. Justin, placing the ring on Christine's finger, repeat after me. Christine, I give you this ring.
Christine, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
To love, honor, and cherish you.
To love, honor, and cherish you.
And Christine,
placing the ring on Justin's finger, repeat after me. Justin, I give you this ring.
Justin, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
To love.
To love.
And cherish you.
Honor and cherish you.
Today, you're making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other and honor your children as well. Your family relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these individual containers of sand, one representing each of you, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. There are children who join in this marriage as well. The gathering of the new family will have a deep influence on them. We realize for the home to be a happy one, it is essential that there be love and understanding between the children and the adults being married. As you each hold your sand, the separate containers represent your lives to this moment, individual and unique. As you combine your sand together, your lives also join as one family. Love exists in itself and continues to take on new meanings as we experience life. The hourglass is an enduring symbol of time. It will now become an enduring symbol of your love and marriage. Each time you turn it, the sands will become more intermingled and remind you of today, your choice to stay together, bound by love, and that this too shall pass, because life and love and marriage will have its ups and downs. At this time, I ask that the bride and groom pour some of your sand into the container, because your marriage is the foundation of your family. Now I ask that the children join you in pouring their sand together with yours to create a beautiful flow of never-ending love and energy. And now I'd like to speak to you two for a moment. Each of you is now a resource into which, as family members, you come to throughout your lifetimes for direction, meaning, and love. Your parents strive to provide not only the basic needs, but a nurturing and loving environment in which each of you finds the confidence to reach the highest goals of your heart. Do you accept the responsibility of being an important part in the building of this family, and to forever contribute your best efforts to maintain its closeness and strength? If so, say, we do.
We do.
Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage and families be. Justin and Christine, inasmuch as you have pledged yourselves each to the other and have declared the same in the presence of this company by the exchange of vows and the giving of rings, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Peebles.
All right, we're going to go ahead and bring in our parents. We're first going to introduce the groom's parents, Shelly and Reggie. Coming in next is the bride's parents, Sherelle and Angie. Next up is Crystal, Sherelle, and Xavier. Now gonna bring in our bridal party. Yeah. I had no intention. First one to introduce Donna and Brandon. They went through me like a knife. I came here with my crew, I lost them. Came with my cool, I dropped it. And if I'm being honest, I'm in. All right now. Come on. Think when you're looking like that. Can't breathe when you're moving like that. Tell me when you're gonna do me like that. Coming in next, I'll let her introduce Michelle and Rich. One trip down, I'ma never go back. But everything's gonna be alright. I think I just met my wife. Yeah, I said it. I know it's gonna be a good night. I would now like to introduce the maid of honor and best man, Alicia Poetry and Vaughn. I'm wondering when the right time is to go and call a kiss. But I'm thinking past that love. I'm ready to meet your mama. If I'm being honest, I'm being honest. All right, ladies and gentlemen, can I please have you stand up? As I would like to introduce, for the second time this evening, Justin and Christine Peebles! Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. All right, let's give it up one more time for our newlyweds. In the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. All right, can we ask everybody please be seated as the newlyweds go into their first dance? This is Stand By Me.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me. the mountain should crumble to the sea. I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stay, stand by.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our newlyweds one more time.